So for today's experiment, Sydney is gonna be performing the MTT assay or the tetrazolium assay. The MTT assay is a proliferation assay. Some literature consider it a viability assay. Also one of the most common cytotoxicity assay. So you notice that the hood had the UV on. However, for the MTT assay, sterility is not essential since it's only for 4 hours, the whole period, and we are gonna discard the cells after doing this assay. One thing is for the MTT assay, it is based on the idea that viable cells that have healthy mitochondria are able to convert the tetrazolium salt that is yellow. Let me show you. So you can see yellow salt into an insoluble formazan crystal that will be solubilized, and then the absorbance will be red. So the cells are grown in these 96 well plates and then treated with the different treatments that you have, either one drug with different concentrations or a different construct for a protein that is either downregulated or overexpressed. For the amount of time that you have specified. Let's look at the cells. And this camera is mono-colored, but hopefully after 4 hours of incubation with the tetrazolium salt, you will be able to see these crystals that we mentioned before. So they are looking good. And now Sydney is gonna add the tetrazolium salt to them. So now Sydney is making up the MTT salt into the working concentration to add it to the cells. It was prepared at a 5 mg/mL, and the final concentration will be 5 µg/mL. So this is what she's doing, just changing the concentration from a stock concentration to a working concentration. And she does that by adding the growing or the growth media to the MTT salt. The next step is for Sydney to aspirate the media that the cells have been growing in, and it depends on the lab you work in, but it could be a vacuum aspiration, it could be pipetting, but you need to aspirate the media, or you need to consider the amount of media you have so that eventually you will have 5 µg/mL final concentration. So Sydney is now just preparing the multi-channel pipette because it is much easier to add one time for a whole column or a whole row. So she's just aspirating the media. So with the multi-channel pipette, she's adding the MTT salt to 8 wells at a time. And she will finish doing this for all the wells in the 296 well plates. So after 4 hours of incubation, what we need to check for is the formation of the formazan crystals, and you can see these dark spots in here. These are the formazan crystals, and these are insoluble. So in order to quantify the differences in proliferation or cytotoxicity. As given by the MTT assay, we need to solubilize that, and we add DMSO isopropanol mixture 1:1. And that's what we are gonna do next step. So what Sydney is gonna do right now is aspirate the media MTT salt. And because the formazan crystals are insoluble, they are not gonna be aspirated with the MTT salt, the growth media mixture. So she's gonna aspirate this from all of the wells. Again, in order to for us to quantify the results of the MTT salt or the MTT assay, we need to solubilize these formazan crystals. So Sydney is now going to add the DMSO isopropanol mixture, which is the solubilizing mixture. And you have to be very careful when you add this mixture, because you have to be constant in what you add to all of the wells so that you don't manipulate the dilution or the concentration of the formazan crystals, because the absorbance will depend on how many of these crystals were formed, and that's based on the proliferation or the viability of your cells. So after 45 minutes of incubation with DMSO and isopropanol solubilizing reagent, we will measure the absorbance of this plate at 570 nanometer. And this is the absorbance of the MTT salt after forming the formazan crystal and being solubilized. And you can see the difference in colors if you compare these wells with the highest concentration of the treatment that we use. You can compare this to the lighter color. And what this indicates, that there are more cells in these wells as compared to this well, which means these wells have more of viable cells as compared to this well. And you need a microplate reader to do this. Our microplate reader is old, but it still works. So this is what I'm gonna do next, is just measure the absorbance at 570 nanometer and then compare the results.